Prime Minister Narendra Modi today launched the first phase of Sauni irrigation project by releasing water from dam gates in Jamnagar. Project to mitigate the problem of water scarcity in Saurashtra region of Gujarat. The 12,000 crore rupees initiative aims to fill 115 irrigation dams of all the 7 districts of Saurashtra with surplus Narmada water. Highlighting other development schemes launched by his government, Prime Minister Modi said that the Ujjwala Yojana aims at distributing 5 crore gas connections by 2019. He said that 45% of gas connections distributed in Uttar Pradesh under this scheme have been given to Dalit families. India and the United States signed an agreement allowing use of each other's land, air and naval bases for repair and resupply. Welcoming the bilateral agreement and logistics exchange, Defence Minister Manohar Parrikar and US Defence Secretary Ashton Carter said the pact will facilitate opportunities for practical engagement. India and US held second strategic and commercial dialogue in New Delhi. The dialogue held to review implementation of decisions taken during previous summit. Summit co-chaired by the visiting US Secretary of State John Kerry, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj and Commerce and Industry Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. Union Urban Development Minister Venkaiah Naidu held review meeting of Swachh Sarvekshan. He said Swachh Sarvekshan aims to create awareness among youth about Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. MOU signed between Urban Development Department and Nehru Yuva Kendra. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley today said the central government employees will get 2 years bonus which was pending. In a press conference in New Delhi, he said that centre has decided to write to all states regarding compliance of contract workers law. Home Ministry is preparing ground for the visit of all party delegation on August 4th and 5th. According to senior officials of MHA, it has already requested the political parties to send the name of their representatives for the delegation. It is expected that a 40-member delegation could go to Jammu and Kashmir. Alleging that forces across the border are fomenting trouble in violence-hit Kashmir, Defence Minister Manohar Parrikar has said that a small percentage of people in the valley are holding the majority to ransom. He said the government is working proactively in handling the violence in the state. Visiting Myanmar President U Thin Chah paid homage to fallen heroes at the India Gate War Memorial in New Delhi. Chah, accompanied by his wife, laid a flower wreath at the memorial. Delhi police has arrested 8 people on suspicion of human trafficking from Delhi. They have been booked under Maharashtra Control of Organized Crime Act. Alleged persons have trafficked more than 5,000 girls from Nepal and remote areas of India. The Delhi High Court on Tuesday directed all civic agencies of the national capital to take preventive steps to control dengue. A bench headed by Chief Justice Rohini Saigal issued notice to the Delhi government and all the civic agencies of the city and asked them to file their response on the steps taken to control the disease. Urgently been evacuated after a blast was reported in Kyrgyz capital Bishkek. The area where the explosion occurred is cordoned off. A car rammed the gates of the Chinese embassy and exploded. One person was killed and several wounded. Bangladesh's Supreme Court has upheld the death sentence it handed down to senior JI leader Mir Qasim Ali for committing war crimes during the country's 1971 Liberation War. Ali is considered as the key financier of Jamaat, which was opposed to Bangladesh's 1971 independence from Pakistan. Wrestler Yogeshwar Dutt's bronze medal from 2012 London Olympics to be upgraded to silver. Reports suggest that the silver medalist deceased Besek Kudukov of Russia has been stripped of his medal for using banned substance. In the US Open tennis tournament, India's Saket Maineni lost his debut Grand Slam match in a 5-set clash to world number 49 Jiří Veselý of Czech Republic in first round. Top seeds Novak Djokovic and Spaniard Rafael Nadal won their respective first round matches with ease.